New York dermatologist Dr. Rita Linkner, she's going to help us dish and debunk those two lies and a truth. Okay, Ish, what do you guess is the truth?
Okay, so I can't go with the lube on my face, and I'm not going with the waxing on my face, so I'm going to keep it organic, man. When in doubt, I'm going organic. I'm going turmeric.
How about you?
Smart. Turmeric.
You guys, that's why you're doctors, right?
Well, I mean turmeric is being touted, and you're Indian.
Yeah. I am. And it's true. I'm Indian.
Turmeric is a part of Indian cooking we know that is so good for us.
Totally.
On so many fronts.
Yeah. Totally. It's a major anti-inflammatory.
Right. I knew that part. Yeah. But I didn't know it was good for skin also.
It's great for skin. I'm of Indian descent. My maiden name is Patel. Okay. I can tell you Indian women bathe in this turmeric bath mask before they get married.
Like literally?
Yes. They do it the day before they get married, and I can tell you it gives you an instantaneous glow.
No kidding.
It's great. So that is the truth. You guys both got it right. Good job.
I guess using the sex lube on your face, not a good idea.
Thumbs down. That one's the lie. There are a couple of active culprits that I would call out on that one that people should be aware of. Mm-hmm. Propylene glycol was allergen of the year dictated by the American Contact Dermatitis Society in 2018.
Okay.
So that active ingredient can cause allergic reactions. So that's why you don't necessarily want to be rubbing it all across your face. And I know people are thinking, but if you're going to use it in your genitalia, why wouldn't you?
Right.
So the architecture, the oil glands, the hair follicles on our face, it's a different environment.
Yes, it is.
I like that. Yes.
It is.
And they're all good environments, they're just different.
Right, just different architecture.
Totally
different. Different architecture.
And then remember, you're going to be putting makeup on top of it. It's going to create different reactions. Castor oil is really common in lubricant too. That can break you out. It can activate rosacea. So that one is the lie. Stay away from the lubricant on the face.
And I would just think by the nature of how oily it is that it could block your pores.
Completely. Yeah. The last thing you want is to get tinea across your face, a yeast infection on the face from using like a castor oil based product. So.
Okay.
So what about the hot video? Waxing on the face and just going all in.
So as a board certified dermatologist, I will tell you go for more permanent routes to remove hair.
Okay.
So laser hair removal. If the hair has no color, you can do electrolysis, which is a little old school, but still works very well.
Okay.
The concern I would have is oftentimes you see the hair grow back coarser and with just an increased density.
With waxing.
Okay. Yeah. So I wouldn't advocate for doing that as a way. Also, it's pretty abrasive, as you see in the videos.
Look,
I think all of us have that kind of knee-jerk reaction, and you don't necessarily, the skin is sensitive on the face, so treat it as such.
I mean, like dermaplaning, essentially shaving for women that have the peach fuzz that they don't like, is that going to have the hair grow back coarser too?
I have seen it. I have. Mm. So if you can invest in the laser hair removal, it's the most permanent way. I can take it from me. I've done it to myself even, but it's the more permanent way to get rid of the hair.
All right. Well, you heard it here. Dr. Linkner, as always, you have set the record straight.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.